So I think it's clear at this point. We are heavily armed in the Nut and Fancy family. 2.86. You guys get that, right? After all these years, I carry pretty much 100% of the time. Tactical Doodle carries pretty much 100% of the time. Mrs. Nut and Fancy carries. To be honest, not 100% of the time. A source of, shall we say, family discussion, and I lose the fight, by the way. What can you do? You know. But yeah, we have a lot of guns in rotation. My youngest son, last suspect, when he gets his carry license, will be carrying it as well. And we have our favorites. I'm going to show you a couple. What do you say? Currently in rotation for the Nut and Fancy family, concealed carry weapon systems. I'll start off with a high firepower favorite. Oh, we like this one. Carried in a shoulder harness beneath a light jacket. Say hello to the Draco. Yes, I'm messing around. Totally kidding. We don't carry that one. I just want to throw it on the table because it's cool. Now, without rule of law, I might throw it in the rotation. Just depends what's going on. You know, I probably have some style of AR-15, actually. That's a cool gun, though. No, we don't carry that. But let me show you actually, I'm just messing around. But now I'm getting serious. A real carry option coming out of the system. Most of these are KelTec products. Deal with it. Still a favorite, the PF9. This one's loaded. Just came out of the holster. Let's see what load I'm running in this. Just 115 jacket hollow point CCI blazer aluminum, which has been out of production for a long time. So sad. Great gun. Still love the PFI. It's a, you know, it's a kind of divisive gun. Some people hate it. Some people love it. I still love it. It works great. I love the PF9. So that's in the system. We run it. If you don't like it, I don't care. It works great for us, and I can shoot it good. Fast and accurate, man. PF9. And it's still a 13-ounce 9mm, super thin. But sometimes, I'm going to talk more on Tactical Doodle's behalf, because usually my minimum carry is a 9mm. These days, it's mostly a Glock 43 or a Glock 26, sometimes a PF9. Sometimes. Carried in a Galco Classic Light shoulder holster, which I don't have here right now. But Tactical Doodle often will carry a P3AT by KelTec. In fact, this is one of its carry pistols right now, and this is how he carries it. I think this is a Galco, yeah, just pocket holster. Let's see what his load is. 90 grain, I think that's Hydra Shock. This load right here. That's what he's running. We've had this ammunition in the family forever, and he's got like a little Packmeyer sleeve on his P3AT. Good gun. Is it my primary way of carrying a 380? Nah, it's just too light. Coming out of the one of my survival kits, I'll just say that, is another P380. This one is unloaded, although we treat it like it's always loaded. I like the gray version. That's cool. And then the subject of this review is another KelTec product. I honestly never thought I would tabletop it, and I've owned it for a long time. And for whatever reason, I just said, I probably ought to do a separate review on it. Say hey to the P32. This is a first-gen P32. I will briefly discuss the differences. And check this out. This is when... Where did it go? Here it is. This is when I bought this gun. Okay, and I'm just going to show you some of the information because I don't want to see it all. So I bought it at Van Wagon and Finance. It used to be a really cool place to buy guns. It's long out of business. Back in 2005. And I paid $239 for it. I don't know if you can see that receipt because it's kind of washing out right here. So $240 back in 2005. Back in 2005, my understanding was they were basically transitioning from the first gen P32, 32 ACP caliber, of course, to the second gen. And your differences are as follows, more or less. The first thing is the one you probably have or would buy right now would be a second gen, and it's a great gun. Some would say it's better than this one. I don't know if I totally buy that. I think this one is a little bit cooler. For one, they used a hexagonal stock for it, as you can see by... Look at that, like the milling of the slide. That was actually the stock. It's just really cool, the first gen. Also, it had the triangle sights on it. So it's not a buckhorn sight where you can see through. You actually stack that triangle on top of the other one. Is it the fastest? Not really. I think I filled that with red fluorescent heck, all the way back in 2005. Has a machined flat extractor on the Gen 1 P32s. And the P3ATs were the same way, is my understanding. Let me show you this one. So this is what your extractor on both the P3ATs and the P32 looks like now. Okay, and there's your front, what do they call that? Your recoil spring catch. Now it's this separate piece. And this Gen 1 P32 is actually an integral piece that would dovetail into the steel slide. So if you have a preference, which one would you buy, Nutton? Well, if you could find a Gen 1 for second cool, I'd probably go Gen 1. As you will see, this one has been very reliable for me. I'm going to show you some shooting video that I did recently of it. I wish I had all the original stuff I did just when we'd go out shooting together as a family. I have had some jams out of this one, though. When it first was new, it seemed like, I don't know, it was about 2 boxes of ammunition. I had about 10 jams. Although the day I was shooting it, it had been dropped in a creek backpacking. Yeah, I was with a friend and we were shooting it. I was like, jam. I'm like, what the freak? And then after that, dried out. Yeah, it's pretty good. And this latest round of testing, it's been phenomenally reliable. Philosophy of use. I introed with it. Concealed carry. 9 is my minimum. I don't use a 380 or even a 32, much more so, as my primary carry. I'll tell you this, though. My gear checks I do with you guys and my friends, there's a lot of 380s being carried. It's almost predominant over the 9 in my gear checks, in my data. And I'm not making that up. I got no agenda here whatsoever other than the truth, as usual. Guys like the 380. It's easy to carry. SAWC is paramount. And the P32, just like the P3AT, but even more so the P32, is a great pocket gun. Okay, I showed you that Galco holster. And, you know, Doodle's running P3AT in there, but that fits perfect. Here's another one. And these are all super affordable. Runs like that. This one actually has a belt clip you can run as a pocket as well. I mean, it's so easy to integrate that into your daily carry, throw it in your back pocket. Be careful of pickpockets, by the way, where depending on where you are, your front pocket, too. Is it the fastest draw? No, but it will be with you when you need it. Another philosophy of use is maybe not the... I mean, you could run the PF9 this way, but all three of these guns, especially P32, are great ankle guns. I'm not a big ankle carry guy because it takes more time and effort to set it up. I have to strap on my holster as I go out for the day. I'm kind of bumping into it, even a small gun, but you can. I think ankle carry, like I've said in past reviews, makes a lot more sense for, you know, reserve police officers. And on duty, I've done that before. I've run ankle guns as a backup to my primary piece. And I know a lot of officers that do as well. So that makes more sense. In civilian life, maybe not so much. How about a women's gun? Absolutely. And one of the huge benefits of the KelTec P32 is it recoils so softly. It's really a different shooting experience between a P3AT, these two guns, definitely a PF9. I mean, a lot of complaints about trigger slap, how uncomfortable the PF9 is to shoot. Some complain about the LCP Rugers and the P3ATs. They're like, P32 is a pussycat. It recoils so lightly. That's important if someone's recoil shy. Job one is actually hitting what you're shooting at, and maybe the P32 is better that way. You know? So light, so compact, though, dude. I mean, geez. It's 8 ounces, by the way, if I remember right. 8 ounces for a P32. Dang, that's lighter than another competitive option I want to shoot. I'm going to show you, which is much beloved here in TMP, man. Yeah. Firepower on the P3AT and the P32 is 7 rounds. I don't know why I keep talking about P3AT. 7 rounds. Is that a lot? One in the chamber, you have a total of 8, if I'm not mistaken. They do have 10-round magazines available. You could use that as your reload. Generally, the way I carry it is going to be in a pocket holster. And I usually have a lint-proof magazine holder available that I'll run. And I'll put the spare magazine in that. But sometimes I'll just run it in like the KelTec zip carry case, like that. And then I'll put the spare mag like that. depending on what system I'm integrating it into. Is it the fast draw? Nope. But I have it. And then this is more ideal in a pocket carry, and then you lint proof that and carry that too. But a 10 round magazine can come along. That's pretty good firepower though for the size of pistol and the weight of pistol, more importantly, that we're talking about. Materials on this gun, by the way, are pretty excellent. The barrel is 4140 steel, so is a slide nowadays. Has a 7075 excuse me, T6 frame in it. And KelTec makes enhancements to all their products over time. Like I introed with, I mean, this is Gen 1, now they have Gen 2. And there's other small tweaks. They've done it with all these guns, a P38T, PF9. You can do some online research and find exactly what they've changed. Forum threads are about it. I like that KelTec is constantly improving their process. They have instituted higher quality standards. We've talked about it on video before in the trade show videos. But I don't have any plans to sell this one. You know, it's a Gen 1 and it's so reliable for me. It's not worth my money. You know, what could I get for this? 200 maybe if I'm lucky. It's better for me just to hang on to it. My philosophy of use, by the way, for this, maybe in some hot weather situations, you know, loading up with a Galco Classic like PF9 or Glock 43 is too much. Throw this in the front pocket. At least you have something. At least you have a gun. And if I gear check and you have a 380, I'm not going to make fun of you. I was like, dude, you got a gun. Good for you. You might be able to stop a, you know, active shooter situation. Granted, you're going to have to be kind of close to them with these pocket pistols. Which leads us to accuracy, by the way. In recent shooting of the P32, I was again reminded that the gun is pretty damn accurate. More so than I ever thought. I mean, back when I bought it in 2005, I did shoot it some. I don't know if I did like formal accuracy tests. This is before TMP, of course. But I did for this review. Here's 6 yards with this load right here, Blazer aluminum. Man, I wish they made these aluminum case rounds. I bet you they quit making them because the internet's like, oh, aluminum case, that's unsafe. CCI goes, roger that, we're gonna quit making them. They save a lot of weight and carries. The aluminum case versus brass, super reliable. Look at that group. Look at this group. This is standing 6 yards with a P32 with these freaking sights. Damn. 19 degrees I shot it this February. I was like, wow. Now, I can't remember if it shoots left or right. I think it wasn't shooting exactly point of aim for me. And no, you can't adjust the sights, obviously. Here's 8 yards standing. And I rode 100%, no jams whatsoever. I forget what load this was. This is a little pocket pistol. Now, like I've said in other pocket pistol mouse gun reviews, don't kid yourself. These are hard to shoot accurately, especially under stress. They're so light, they're so tiny, it's easy to wobble them around. I don't know if their calling is exactly to do that, to shoot super accurate at longer distances. They're close contact, usually backup weapons, backup pistols. And that's why the sights are somewhat secondary. I've always said I like really good sights. Reference my SIG P938 and 238 reviews. And those have really great sights on them, but they're very diminutive pistols. I would say the accuracy, therefore, is amazing. Amazing. And there are some great defensive loads out there for 32 auto, and it's super quick, you know, which one's better between these two. Here's a Corbon 60 grain load. I do carry this. Or the 380. I would go with a 380. It's going to hit harder, have better penetration, and it's a better cartridge. It's true rimless. This is not. And what I'm talking about is here's two 32 ACP rounds, Corbon on the right. You see it's shorter overall length for one. And then also, as I rub these two together, you can see they'll actually rim lock with each other. And that's something that can happen in the magazine of the P32. And therefore, KelTec sells spacers for the shorter rounds. You don't have to worry about it with the longer rounds because they'll stack directly on top of each other. But the shorter rounds, they can actually rim lock and prevent feeding. And you'll put it in the back as a space in the back of your magazine, and therefore your Corbons will feed. When I was testing, I was shooting mostly FMJs. I did shoot some Corbons and some Winchester Silver Tips, and I did take the spacers out, and I didn't have a problem that day. But it's probably a good idea with these 32 ACP rounds to put your spacer on if they're short around. But I don't want to get hit by this round. I mean, it'll run about 125 to 150 foot-pounds of energy. With a super fast loads, you might get around 900 to 1,000 feet per second out of them, out of this little short 2.7-inch barrel. That's something. And it's easy to shoot. It's a pussycat, like I said. One thing I meant to say is it does have a last shot hold open, which I think the P380 lacks. There you go. So that's your clue bird that you're out of ammunition. So you just put a new magazine in. Features review is going to be similar to my P380 review I did, what, like 2008 for that gun? It's a long time ago. The magazine release is where I'll start. Be careful when you're shooting the gun. It's easy to actuate it. When I reviewed the LCP, I talked about how that is a little bit of an improvement. They have, you know, some barriers there to an inadvertent mag release, mag drop. Just practice your hold. You know, good trigger guard, though. You will get some rub in the bottom right here. But who cares? It's a pistol, you know. It's a, I should say, a pocket gun. Positive magazine ejection. I like that. We talked about the materials. Again, in this Gen 1, I really like the slide and how it looks. That's cool. I think the sights on the Gen 2 are better. They're going to be paintable or more paintable and better contrast. Maybe some more precision on it. The trigger is what you would expect for a pocket pistol. I'm not going to pull it. I mean, it's heavy. Long, heavy pull, but it's simple. There's nothing to snag on. No safeties to worry about. All good, man. How about reliability? I think I've hit on that already. I did have some jams early on. Some of these pocket pistols would need a break-in time. We talked about that in other reviews years ago. Overall, though, I would say the reliability on this one, it's been really good. Really good. You may have some guys come in the comments say, well, this one sucked for me. Welcome to everything. I mean, all these things can fail. I mean, how many times have I said that? And that will take us, I guess, to accessories. Here's one you might think of. This is a belt clip from KelTec. And by the way, KelTec accessories are so inexpensive. You go direct to their website. You don't have to worry about getting ripped off. So you put a belt clip on, and you talk about a really slim, easy to carry package. Cool. The 10-round magazines I've discussed already. They also have a one-round extension for the mags. I would probably be a little bit careful about that because you're going to reduce your spring tension on the magazine. You might induce some stoppages. And I've also seen with these magazines, to include the PF9, you can lose your base plate. So if you drop it, this pin pops out. Next thing you know, your base plate's off and your whole magazine with rounds in it disassembles. If it were up to me, I would put a stronger spring in all these KelTec pistols. Just me. The soft case is a plus. I love that. Good way to carry it too if you're a lady and you're carrying it in your purse because it encloses the trigger so you don't have to worry about that. It keeps the gun clean, dust free. There are different grip modules, different colorations for the P32 as you can see as well for the P380. How about competitive options? How about there's lots. One of my favorites, and I've talked to you guys about this, I did a separate update video on it, is the discontinued but oh so wicked Beretta 950 Jetfire in 25 auto. By the way, every time I show this on camera, we get bids for it. Hey, nothing. I want to buy that 950. We're not selling it, dude. Not gonna happen. This is actually heavier than a P32 though. 10 ounces, 8 ounces, unloaded. But what was this? 8+1. So incredible firepower, super fast shooting. Single action trigger with a safety, so it's a little bit more complex to work, the Beretta Jetfire. And the 25 auto is it a great cartridge? Probably not, but it beats 22 long rifle. It's much more reliable than 22 long rifle. I still love the Jetfire. It's so cool. It's also a great ankle carry, great backup gun. Ammo's expensive, hard to find. If I was to hit a bad guy with a 25 auto or a 32, not counting the 380 or the 9, I'd probably go with a 32. You may want to think about how your round will or will not expand, though. I have shot rounds out of the 32. I've looked at them, and they didn't expand at all. Same with the 25. You might just be better off with going with FMJs for maximum penetration, going through clothes, maybe a light obstacle. Just a thought. I will say the Corban does have a great expanding record out of a 32, depending on the media. Competitive options, the P380 has been on the table the whole time. Ruger LCP and some others I'm not going to cover just for time, man. I love the P32. I love the P380, honestly. Great guns both. Are they the best in the market? Well, we live in great times when there's a lot to choose from. You know, I don't know if they're the best, but they're definitely worth the money. You it inherits that high value equation that KelTec almost always gives them or gives us. Also, witness this. I don't see a lot of P32s up for sale. It's like people get them and they just hang on to them. Maybe I missed it, but I don't know. Track record's been good. Oh, one thing you might want to remember is don't dry fire it. Same with the P3AT. There's a warning in the manual that it could actually lead to damage for reasons you can read in there. Another reason I like the last shot hold open. Great pistol. Super, super light. Great backup piece. That's the Nutnfancy review. See you.
Man, I haven't shot this gun in about 7 years. Silver tip out of the KelTec P32. It's a tiny, tiny gun. Let's see how it does.
It's cold out here too, about 20 degrees.
Yeah. Check this. Actual P32 accuracy. Excellent. Daddy-like.